Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to CMI's online classes. In today's class, for the students of Standard 7, we will continue with Chapter 7 of our English grammar, that is the present tenses. So, as I've already told you in our previous videos on the same chapter, that we are going to understand all the present tenses from the classification of tenses, different tenses. So, as I have already told you that the tenses are classified into four major kinds, that are simple tenses, continuous tenses, perfect tenses and perfect continuous tenses. So, we are taking all present tenses from these classification of tenses. Likewise, in our previous videos on the same chapter, we have already understood with the sentence structures of the simple present tense from simple tenses, present continuous tense from continuous tenses, and present perfect tense from perfect tenses. And in today's video, we are going to understand present perfect continuous tense from perfect continuous tenses. So here in this video we are going to understand present perfect continuous tenses. So as I have already told you in our previous videos on the same chapter about continuous tenses, that continuous tenses, the sentence structure of continuous tenses are be verbs plus before, and perfect tenses to have verbs plus V3. But if you see in this video, if we are going to understand what kind of actions are expressed in present perfect continuous tense, it is perfect also and continuous also. That means we have to make the use of to be verbs plus V4 as well as to have verbs plus V3. So, how are we going to manage these uses of forms of verbs? Because we have both perfect and continuous tenses together. So, how are we going to manage the use of to have verb plus V3 as well as to be verbs plus V4? That here we have to understand. And we also have to understand that what kind of actions are expressed in present perfect continuous tense. What is the sentence structure? So, if you see, just we have to understand at first, it is very important to understand the sentence structures. सबसे पहले हमें ये जानना है कि present perfect continuous tense का sentence structure क्या होगा. क्योंकि जैसे हमने पहले वीडियो में जाना है कि perfect tenses में हम perfect tense हम कैसे परफेक्ट टेंस का सेंटेंस स्ट्रक्चर कैसे होगा, सब्जेक्ट प्लस टू हैव वर्ब प्लस V3 मेन यूज ऑफ वर्ब फॉर्म्स वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इज टू हैव वर्ब प्लस V3. एंड अगेन इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी अंडरस्टूड प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. सो आई टोल्ड यू दैट वी फ्रेम कंटिन्यूअस टेंसेस विद द सेंटेंस स्ट्रक्चर वेयर वी यूज the verb forms like to be verb plus before. So here in this tense, present perfect continuous tense, जहां पर perfect भी है continuous tense, continuous भी है. तो perfect जहां पर to have verb plus V3 है और continuous जहां पर to be verb plus V4 है. तो ये दोनों को हमें मिलाकर जाना है. We have to make use of both the forms of verbs. लेकिन हम ये दोनों को हम मैनेज कैसे करेंगे. सो लेट अस फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड द सेंटेंस स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस एंड देन वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द एक्शंस दैट आर एक्सप्रेस्ड इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. सो प्रेजेंट भी है, परफेक्ट भी है, कंटिन्यूअस भी है. ओके, सो वी विल अंडरस्टैंड पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस ऑल्सो एंड फ्यूचर परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस ऑल्सो व्हेन वी विल कम टू another, that means coming chapters that are based on past tenses and future tenses. In past tenses, we will understand all past tenses, from simple tenses, continuous tenses, perfect tenses, as well as perfect continuous tenses. And we will also cover future tenses. That means all future tenses where we have to understand simple future tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, and future perfect continuous tense. So we will understand each and every tense with the sentence structure, sentence structures, as well as the kinds of actions that are expressed in each tense. Till now we have covered three present tenses, that means simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, and in this video we are going to understand present perfect continuous tense. So सबसे पहले हम present perfect continuous tense का sentence structure क्या होगा, कैसा होगा, ये हम पहले जानेंगे, और उसके बाद present perfect continuous tense से हम किस तरीके का actions को express करेंगे, बयां करेंगे, वो भी हम जानेंगे इस video में. So present भी है, perfect भी है, continuous भी है. तो whether we write the sentences in any tense, there should be subject at first. Subject plus perfect है. So perfect, as I have told you that to have verb plus B3, तो present है. तो either we have to use has or have. If the subject is singular, we have to use has, and if the subject is plural, we have to use have. And now, after using has or have, as we have understood that in perfect tenses we have to use B3. Now here, this requirement of B3 in this tense we will fulfill with the use of B3 form of to be verbs. B3 form of to be verbs, not the main verbs, to be verbs. Okay, so B3 form of to be verbs is been. Now, again we have to use like. See, like in perfect tenses, we always frame perfect tenses by using has or have, to have verb plus B3. So here it is fulfilled here. To have verbs, has or have. In place of to have verbs, we have has or have, and B3. The requirement of B3 we have fulfilled by using B3 form of to be verbs, been. And now B4, that is here, we will use B4 here. Main verb is B4 here. And after that, rest of the sentence. Okay, so what is the sentence structure of present perfect continuous tense? That is subject plus has or have plus been plus B4 plus rest of the sentence. Rest part of the sentence. So this is the final structure of present perfect continuous tense when we write them in sentences. So we may write affirmative sentences. This is the structure of affirmative sentences when we write affirmative sentences in present perfect continuous tense. Now we may also write negative sentences in present perfect continuous tense. That we have already understood that negative sentences means sentence that the sentences that carry no or not. Understood. And we also have understood in our previous videos to frame interrogative sentences in each tense. So here also we can frame interrogative sentences in present perfect continuous tenses, continuous tense also. So what is the sentence structure that we will understand in this video? Okay, so the sentence structure that you see here on the screen, this is the sentence structure of present perfect continuous tense, and this is affirmative. Affirmative, that means positive sentence. When we write positive or affirmative sentence in present perfect continuous tense, the sentence structure will be like this. Okay, now if we add subject plus has or have plus not plus been plus B4 plus rest of the sentence, it becomes negative. Now interrogative, has or have plus subject plus been plus before plus rest of the sentence. This is the sentence structure of present perfect continuous tense when we write the sentence in interrogative sentences, but in present perfect continuous tense. Understood how we will write this sentence structure, how will we frame sentences with this sentence structure, we will understand in the later part of this video. So at first, now we will understand what are the actions that are expressed in present perfect continuous tenses. See, number one, actions which began in the past and continue up to the time of speaking. Present bhi hai, continuous bhi hai. So, perfect bhi hai, continuous bhi hai. Perfect means complete. Okay. So, present perfect continuous tense mein hum kaise actions ko bayan karenge? Actions which began in the past. Aisa kaam jo kuch samay pehle kya hua hai? Shuru hua hai. Bita hua time mein shuru hua hai. लेकिन एट द टाइम ऑफ स्पीकिंग, जब उस काम के बारे में हम बोल रहे हैं, वो काम कंटिन्यू हो रहा हो, क्योंकि कंटिन्यूस है तो कंटिन्यू होना ही है. तो ऐसा काम जो कुछ समय पहले या बीता हुआ समय में शुरू हुआ हो, लेकिन बोलते समय, जिस काम के बारे में हम बोल रहे हैं उस समय वो काम क्या हो रहा हो, कंटिन्यू हो रहा हो, तो ऐसे कामों को हम प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूस टेंस से हम एक्सप्रेस करते हैं. लाइक ही हैज बीन वॉचिंग टीवी सिंस मॉर्निंग. सो उसका ये सब्जेक्ट जो ही है, उसका क्या है, टीवी देखने का काम मॉर्निंग से शुरू हुआ है. दैट मीन्स बीता हुआ समय, मॉर्निंग. सिंस मॉर्निंग मीन्स जो सुबह था, जो वो सुबह काम शुरू हो चुका है, लेकिन अभी भी क्या है, वो काम टीवी देखने का काम कंटिन्यू हो रहा है. सो डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? सो ऐसा काम जो कुछ समय पहले शुरू हुआ है, कुछ समय पहले मीन्स सुबह शुरू हो चुका है अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस सेंटेंस. बट नाउ आई एम टेलिंग दिस सेंटेंस दैट व्हेन आई एम स्पीकिंग अबाउट द एक्शन ऑफ वॉचिंग, दिस एक्शन ऑफ वॉचिंग इज स्टिल गोइंग ऑन. ओके. सो व्हेन एवर वी राइट एफर्मेटिव सेंटेंसेस इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट टेंसेस, सो दे कैरी since, from or for. So when we write sentences in present perfect continuous tense, the sentences usually have the prepositions like since, from or for. Like here, he has been watching TV since morning. So when we use these prepositions, okay, the use of these prepositions give us the sense of the action that had been or that have been started in the past time. Okay, like I have been teaching my students for 2 hours. That means before 2 hours, the action has been started, but still that action is going on. Okay. As I have told you, we use has or have depending upon the number of subjects. So here he, the subject is he here. It is singular, so has. Has is singular. Now been is the Bhitri form of the be verb and watching is before. So we have used all. To have verbs also we have used. B3 form of the verbs also we have used, and before form of the verbs we have also used. So that is the requirement of this perfect continuous tense. क्योंकि perfect भी है जिसे हम to have verbs के साथ B3 का use करेंगे, जिसमें हम टू हैव वर्ब्स के साथ बी3 का यूज करेंगे, कंटिन्यूअस भी है जिसमें हम टू बी वर्ब्स के साथ बी4 का यूज करेंगे। इसका मतलब हम इस टेंस में टू हैव वर्ब्स का भी इस्तेमाल करेंगे, बी3 का भी इस्तेमाल करेंगे और बी4 का भी इस्तेमाल करेंगे। सो ये व्हेन यू रीड दिस सेंटेंस एंड यू व्हेन यू सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस सेंटेंस, हमने यहां पर टू हैव वर्ब्स का भी इस्तेमाल किया है, बी3 फॉर्म का भी इस्तेमाल किया है और बी4 फॉर्म का भी इस्तेमाल किया है। ओके, वेदर एनी काइंड ऑफ एक्शंस दे एक्सप्रेस, दे ऑलवेज हैव टू हैव वर्ब प्लस बी3 प्लस बी4। बी3 वी विल फुलफिल द रिक्वायरमेंट बाय यूजिंग बी3 ऑफ टू बी वर्ब्स। ओके, नाउ अनदर पॉइंट्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द एक्शन दैट आर एक्सप्रेस इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस, लाइक पास्ट एक्शन ऑफ सर्टेन ड्यूरेशन विद विजिबल रिजल्ट्स इन द प्रेजेंस। जो काम पास्ट में शुरू हुआ हो और उसका असर और उसका रिजल्ट हमें प्रेजेंट में दिखने को मिल रहा हो। ओके, जो काम पहले ही शुरू हुआ हो और उसका असर हमें प्रेजेंट में दिखने को मिल रहा हो, तो ऐसे कामों को भी हम प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस में हम एक्सप्रेस करते हैं। लाइक ही हैज बीन वॉकिंग इन द रेन, ही हैज बीन वॉकिंग इन द रेन। ओके, सो दैट इज व्हाई ही हैज गॉट अ कोल्ड। सो व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ द एक्शन, ही हैज गॉट कोल्ड। व्हाई? बिकॉज ही हैज बीन वॉकिंग इन द रेन। नाउ सेकेंड इज, ही हैज बीन इग्नोरिंग हिज स्टडीज फॉर सम टाइम नाउ। सो ही हैज बीन इग्नोरिंग, पहले से ही क्या है वो क्या कर रहे हैं, क्या कर रहे थे या क्या कर रहे हैं, पढ़ाई में ध्यान नहीं दे रहा है। व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट? दैट इज व्हाई ही हैज नॉट डॉन वेल इन द टेस्ट। सो उसका रिजल्ट क्या हुआ है, उसका टेस्ट में उसने अच्छा नहीं किया है। सो द प्रेजेंट रिजल्ट विच इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ द पास्ट एक्शन, इन दैट केस ऑल्सो वी विल एक्सप्रेस और राइट सेंटेंसेस इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। नाउ द अनदर पॉइंट्स टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एक्शन इज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस इज टू एक्सप्रेस एंगर और अनोयंस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल। सो टू एक्सप्रेस एंगर, अपना गुस्सा बयां करने के लिए या अपना इग्नोरेंस बयान करने के लिए। अनोयंस मीन्स इग्नोरेंस। ओके, समवन हैज बीन फिडलिंग विद माई फोन, has been, so this is also the present action which is going continuously going on. Okay, now Sudha has been trying to wake me up since the minute I fell asleep. So this is annoyance. Okay, this is anger. Okay, so I hope you have understood. So now the structure of sentence. So affirmative, I told you affirmative means positive sentences. Negative means the sentences that carry no or not in them. And interrogative sentences means question sentences. Now see here, I have been sleeping. This is present perfect continuous tense in affirmative, positive sense. Okay. Now negative sentence. As I've told you, the sentence structure earlier, that subject plus has or have. Here we have used have after I, subject is I because have is the plural verb and has is the singular verb. Okay, so have is used when the subject is plural or subjects are either I or you, because with I or you whenever we use the verbs they are always plural. Okay, so here I have been sleeping. This is in positive sense. Now I have not been sleeping. So before the use of B3 and after to have verbs, we will use not in negative sentence when we write negative sentence in present perfect continuous tense. Okay, so if you see, this present perfect continuous tense always carry to have verb plus B3 plus B4. Okay, yahan par to have verb plus B, to have verb bhi hai, B3 bhi hai as well as B4 bhi hai. Now interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences in present perfect continuous tense. So we will use helping verb. We already have helping verb, auxiliary verb have. Okay. So this helping verb we will use at the beginning of the sentence. So as I have already told you, whenever we frame sentences, interrogative sentences by using helping verbs, चाहे वो कोई भी helping verb हो, यहाँ पर have है, तो हम कोई भी helping verb को लेकर हम interrogative sentences या तो question sentences हम बना सकते हैं. तो जब भी हम question sentences बनाते हैं by using helping verbs, so उस समय helping verbs को सबसे पहले होना चाहिए, sentence से पहले. सेंटेंस और सब्जेक्ट आता है उस समय हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स और मेन वर्ब्स के बीच में. ओके, सो हियर हैव इज हेल्पिंग वर्ब, सो आई हैव यूज्ड हैव हियर. देन सब्जेक्ट, एंड हियर इन इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस व्हेन वी फ्रेम इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंस इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस, सब्जेक्ट कम्स बिटवीन हेल्पिंग वर्ब एंड मेन वर्ब लाइक अदर इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस विथ हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स. So, helping verbs, main verbs, B3 form. So, here in present perfect continuous tense, subject comes between B3 form of be verbs and the helping verb. Okay. Now, see, you have been sleeping. You have not been sleeping. Negative. Have you not been sleeping? Have you been sleeping? Interrogative sentence. Now, interrogative sentence in negative sense. These are the interrogative sentences in positive sense, affirmative interrogative sentences. Now negative interrogative sentences like have I not been sleeping or have you been sleeping, have you not been sleeping, negative sentences. Okay, in interrogative, in present perfect continuous tense, like he has been sleeping. See, has we have used because subject is singular. He has not been sleeping. Negative. Has he been sleeping? Interrogative sentence in affirmative sense. Has he not been sleeping? Interrogative sentence in negative sense. Now she has been sleeping. She has not been sleeping. Negative. Has she been sleeping? Interrogative sentence in positive sense or affirmative sense. Has she not been sleeping? Interrogative sentence in negative sense. Okay, now see, we have been sleeping, we, plural, so have, B1, plural, we have been sleeping, we have not been sleeping, negative sense. Now, have we been sleeping, interrogative sentence in positive sense. Now, interrogative sentence in negative sense is, have we not been sleeping. Okay, I hope you have understood the explanation of present perfect continuous tense. And now you are able to frame sentences with the correct sentence structure in present perfect continuous tense. And you have already understood the kinds of actions that are expressed in present perfect continuous tense. But still, if you have any kinds of doubts, kindly raise your doubts. Keep your problems in the class so that we will have discussion to clear all the confusions. So this much for today's class. Thank you so much, students, for attending my class today.